Okay, magandang araw sa ating mga grade 10 students. Sa video lesson na ito, ang gagawin natin ay ang activity 2, what's in the reaction. So, continuation po ito ng chemical reaction na ginawa natin na actual na mga chemicals na pinag-combine natin. Ito naman ang gagawin natin, na-express natin sa chemical equation. So, review muna po tayo ng ilang elements at ang kanilang mga chemical symbol. Ito, number 1. Okay, Au. What element is this? Okay, gold. What about Fe? Okay, iron. What about H? Okay, hydrogen. What about Ag? Okay, silver. What about Hg? Okay, mercury. Okay, another. O. Okay, oxygen. What about Cu? Okay, copper. What about C? Okay, carbon. Mn, manganese, and S, sulfur. So, napakarami pa po ng ating mga elements. So, ilan lang yan? So, okay, carbon dioxide. What about number 2? Okay, copper sulfate. What about number 3? Okay, kilalang-kilala natin yung chemical na yan, water. And then number 4, sodium hydroxide. And number 5, sodium chloride. So, proceed po tayo sa ating activity 2, what's in a reaction. So, for our objectives, distinguish between reactants and products. Ano bang pagkakaiba nitong reactants and products at ano ba ito? Number 2, write a chemical equation. Okay, reactants and products. When you say reactants are substances that are used up to form new substances in a chemical reaction. Reactants are substances that start a chemical reaction. And kapag sa equation na po, ito yung karaniwan nasa kaliwa, yung reactants. And then products are substances produced in a reaction. A chemical reaction can be represented by the general chemical formula, reactants, and then may arrow, products. Kung titignan natin, ang reactants po, ito yung mga nasa kaliwang part ng arrow, and then the products are in the right side. Pwede pong ang reactant ay isa or dalawa, reactant, isa, reactants. Pwede rin ang products po isa or product isa or dalawa or higit pa. So, reactants and products. Reactants are substances that are used up to form new substances in a chemical reaction. The following chemical reaction took place in activity 1, procedure A to E, yung ginawa po natin. So, nasa description po yung mga actual na ginawa nating mga ginamitan natin ng mga chemicals kung saan nakita natin ang actual yung chemical reaction. So for number 1, iron reacts with copper sulfate and forms iron 2 sulfate and copper. So number 2, magnesium combines with oxygen gas to produce magnesium oxide. And number 3, hydrogen peroxide in the presence of manganese dioxide produces water and oxygen gas. And number 4, acetic acid and sodium bicarbonate produce sodium acetate with the release of carbon dioxide gas and water. And number 5, copper sulfate reacts with sodium hydroxide to produce insoluble copper hydroxide and sodium sulfate solution. So, yan naman po ang mga gagawa natin ng dito sa table na to. Okay, dito sa table po na ito, dito natin ilalagay yung sagot based dun sa 1 to 5 na chemical reactions ipinakita sa sentences. Sasagutan natin by means naman ng table. So, palakin po natin itong table. Yung number 1, kung babalikan natin, so, iron, ang symbol po ng iron is Fe, and copper sulfate, ito yung mga reactants. And then, ang products ay iron 2 sulfate and copper. So, yan po yung mga products. So, sa number 2, magnesium and oxygen ang reactants. And then, ang products po, yung MgO, ano po yan? So, balikan nyo po. So, balikan nyo po yung limang reactants and products in sentence form kung alin yan. And then number 3, yon blanco. Ano yung dalawang reactants? Balikan nyo po yung number 3. Sige, balikan po natin yung number 3. Ito po yung number 3. Hydrogen peroxide in the presence of manganese dioxide produces water and oxygen gas. So, alin dyan yung sa number 3? So, sa product po, binigay na ang products ay water and oxygen. Okay, for number 4. So, ang reactants, dalawa po yan, acetic acid at ano yung isa? So, balikan nyo po yung sentence form ng ating reactants and products. And then products, we have carbon dioxide and blank again. Mm. So hanapin nyo. And then number 5, ano yung dalawang reactants? At ano yung dalawang products? So balikan natin yung number 5, tingnan natin. So ito pa yung number 5, copper sulfate, CuS2, is O2, reacts with sodium hydroxide to produce insoluble copper hydroxide and sodium sulfate solution. So ayan po, makita natin kung alin dyan ang products and reactants. Ayan, good luck po sa pagsagot nyo sa table na to. Kayang-kaya nyo yun, napakasimple na. For part B, symbols used in chemical equation. There are other symbols used in writing a chemical equations. So sa table 7 na to, nandito yung mga symbols and meaning. Plus, to show combination of reactants or products. Yung susunod natin na mga activities, gagamitin natin yan, mga symbol po na yan. And then yung arrow naman, ito yung to produce, to form, to yield, or resulting to, pwede natin gamitin yan. Ito yung nagsiseparate. Itong arrow na to, ito ang nagsiseparate ng reactants and products. Yung reactants nasa kaliwa ng arrow, yung reactants nasa kaliwa ng arrow, at yung products ay nasa kanan ng arrow. So, kapag involved po yung solid, liquid, or gas, nilalagyan po natin ng SLG, and kapag AQ po, aqueous substance is dissolved in water. Kapag ginamit naman po ng dalawang arrow na to, meaning reversible reaction, na kapag yung kagaya ng photosynthesis and respiration, yun, kino-consider po yun na reversible reaction. So, kumbaga yung sa photosynthesis, the reactants are the water, carbon dioxide, hindi po ba? At ang products naman ay oxygen and carbohydrates. Kapag binaliktad po natin, ang gagawin nating reactants, ay yung carbohydrates and oxygen. Ang mangyayari, ang product ay ang water and then carbon dioxide, ang tawag po doon is respiration. So may mga ganun pong equation na reversible ang reaction. So okay, pwedeng lagyan ng heat. So, indicates that heat is supplied to the reaction. And then PT, a formula written above or below the yield sign, indicates is used as a catalyst or solvent. So using the symbols and formulas in table 6 and the symbols in table 7, write the chemical reaction using these symbols to complete chemical equation. So ano yung mga symbols? About number 1, ayan. Iron combined or reacts with copper sulfate resulting to iron sulfate and copper. So ayan po yung chemical equation na kapag kinonvert natin sa sentence, mas mahaba. And then, tingnan natin kung may sagot pang given. Okay, number 5. Yung 2, 3, 4, kayo na po. Kayang-kaya nyo na yan. Based doon sa, balikan nyo lang po yung table na ginawa natin and then yung sentences. Copper sulfate, ito sa number 5, copper sulfate reacts or combined with sodium hydroxide resulting to copper hydroxide and sodium sulfate. So, yan po yung chemical equation. So, sagutan nyo na po ang 2, 3, and 4. Kayang-kaya na natin yan. O pwede nyo pong i-comment down yung sagot nyo dito sa table 8, yung 2, 3, and 4. So, a chemical equation represents the way in which a reaction rearranges the atoms in reactant. So, yung sa chemical equation nga po pala, kung itutulad natin sa yung sa element, sa symbol, parang yung symbol ng element is kagaya ng letter ng alphabet. And then kapag pinagsama-sama yung dalawang element or higit pa, ang tawag na natin is compound, that is equivalent to word. Kapag naman pinagsama-sama na natin yung mga words, di ba sentence ang nabubuo? Sa chemical equation, ang katapat nun is chemical equation, that is the sentence. So to write an equation, you must know the reactants and products. So dapat alam natin i-identify ano yung reactants, alin yung products. Ano po? So kita naman natin sa sentence kung alin ang reactants, alin ang products. So, atomic symbols and formulas of the reactants and products. So, kailangan po natin dito ng periodic table of element. So, atomic symbols and formulas of the reactants and products. Direction of the reaction. An arrow is used to separate the reactants and products and to show the direction of change. The reactants are written on the left of the arrow while the products on the right. A double arrow is sometimes used. This indicates a reversible reaction. This means that as they are produced, products are also converted back to the reactants. Kagaya nga na po binanggit ko yung sa photosynthesis and then the respiration process. Pwede siyang reversible reaction. So for our key concept, a chemical equation is a chemist's shorthand for a chemical reaction. So pinaikli, kung papansin po natin, i-compare mo dun sa sentence na napakahaba, kapag ginamitan na natin ng chemical equation and symbol, mas pinaiiksi yung space na na-occupy. So, para din po yan dun sa scientific notation. So, kung wala ang scientific notation, napakalalaki at napakaliliit na number. Sobrang dami ng space na ma-occupy. So, ganun din po ang the purpose of the chemical equation. The equation differentiates between the reactants, which are starting materials, and the products, which are the resulting substance or substances. It shows the symbols for or formulas of the reactants and products, the phases, solid, liquid, gas of the substances, and the ratio of the substances as they react. So good luck sa ating mga grade 10 students. Ang susunod po natin na video lesson, we are going to balance the equation. Kasi po hindi pa balance yung mga ginawa natin na equation. So, isa sa mga rules in chemical equation that it should be balanced.